What did you guys think of the scene in The Last Jedi that depicted the fall of Ben Solo to the dark side? So the scene I'm talking about was shown in three different perspectives. So it was shown in Luke's initial perspective, the first way that he told Rey. It was shown from Kylo Ren's perspective, or Ben Solo's perspective. And then finally, it was shown in Luke's second version. So all of these perspectives were told to Rey to kind of give her a certain view, certain point of view of what occurred. So why Ben left the Jedi Academy and Luke and joined Snoke and the dark side. So there's so much to unpack in all of these scenes. In the first depiction by Luke, Luke isn't using a lightsaber at all. It just shows him kind of visiting Kylo and then Kylo attacking him. And, you know, like that's how the dark side really manifests itself in him. And he just like went, and like attacked Luke and kind of destroyed the Jedi Academy. In Kylo Ren's version, it had Luke attacking Kylo specifically with the lightsaber. And I know right when I first saw that scene, I thought, wow, that's just totally different from Luke's version. And how is Luke going to explain that? And then it kind of came back to Luke, and he did a pretty decent job, I thought, of explaining that he was ashamed. He thought about killing Kylo, but then restrained himself. So, It's interesting you had these three perspectives going on, and two of them from Luke, kind of one of his censored version for Rey, and then his other version that depicted his own shame. So which of these versions do you think is really the true version? I mean, I would argue that both of the second versions are true. So the first version that Luke told without the lightsaber at all is the version that he probably would like to tell himself and others, because it doesn't really show him in a bad light. So that's how I see that first version. The second version with Kylo Ren, from his perspective, I think that Kylo believes that Luke was out to get him, because Luke came into his room and the lightsaber was on, and you know, Kylo's just sort of waking up, and he probably was pretty terrified by that, and it looked like his master was going to kill him. So I think that point of view is true. And then finally, Luke's later point of view was kind of Luke coming to terms with the truth. So that's how Luke perceived the events unfolding, you know, coming to Kylo's room and restraining himself. So yeah, I think all of the perspectives are true from a certain point of view, as Obi-Wan famously said. So I guess what Rian Johnson was trying to do in this scene, showing this scene three ways, well, a few things. First, it was just, it was a way to illustrate that famous Ben Kenobi line about, you know, what I told you was true from a certain point of view. So it's kind of coming full circle back to that line. It's also a reference to the Akira Kurosawa film Rashomon, which portrays an event in a few different perspectives as well. So what did you guys think of that? I mean, one thing to think about it, another way to consider it though, is Star Wars doesn't traditionally use flashbacks. I guess in Revenge of the Sith, you had a little view of the future, because Anakin would have these nightmares of Padme dying and stuff. And, well, she did turn out to die. But other than that, I mean, Star Wars is known for kind of being in the present almost. So what do you think about that use of the different perspectives? Do you think that it was a nice nod to Rashomon and previous Star Wars movies? Or do you think just that filming choice was inappropriate for Star Wars? I'd love to hear what you think in the comment section.